My name is Yvette. I'm one of the student nurses here, and I was hopeful that you might allow me to do a head-to-toe medical inspection of you. With your consent, of course. I'm still learning, so there are some areas that I maybe need a little bit of a refresher or might be a little bit slower with. If you can be patient with me, I would greatly appreciate it. Thank you. So, if it's okay with you, can we start with some of the basics? Do you mind refreshing, making sure that I have the correct patient with the correct information? Can you tell me your name, height, and weight, approximately? Well, your name, not your approximate name, your name. Okay. And when was the last time that you had seen a medical professional? Were there any major concerns that you had for us this afternoon? Did you have any pain, any medical concerns, discomfort in the last couple of days, or medical history that you'd like to go over? Okay. Your ears? Okay. Are you prone to ear infections or anything like that? Okay. And when was the last time that you had any major episode with your ears? And did you receive any treatment for that? How'd that go? Yeah. You think it's just dryness, maybe? Okay. Well, I can make suggestions and recommendations based on my examination. And then if the doctor thinks that a prescription would be appropriate, we'll get you one. Okay. I'm going to start with your vitals. I'm going to start with your blood pressure, and I'm going to use a cuff on your upper arm here, so if you don't mind just holding your arm out. Okay, thank you. Just relax your arm. You'll feel it's getting a little bit tight. Try to relax your arm. The anticipation is killing you. It's a little bit elevated. Are you nervous? Okay. Thank you. Do you normally have any kind of hypertension or anxiety that you're aware of while you're around doctors? Well, I'm a nurse, so not quite the same. Okay. But in the same way. You're in your own calmer environment, sometimes it can be much, much more relaxing and your blood pressure will go down. Okay, I'm going to take your temperature. Okay, I'm going to put a new cuff on that. Alrighty. And again, this one takes a while. Right on where we wound it. And 8.6. Okay. Going to take your pulse. Do you mind holding up your wrists here? Okay, I'm just going to feel both wrists. symmetry, which is good. Lovely. And I'm also going to do your pulse on one wrist and on your neck here. Do you mind if I touch your neck? Listen to your lungs and your heart. Now we're not going to do anything special, so just breathe like you normally would, okay? Thank you. Gonna reach around to the back. Okay, do you mind saying the word 99 for me? And again? And again. Again on your right side here. Can you say 99 for me? Okay. And again. And again. Okay. Sounds good. I'm going to take a listen to your heart and your chambers here. So, again, not going to focus on any kind of special breathing or holding your breath or anything, just normal. Lift up your arm a little bit for me. Thank you. Kind of on the back here, so. I'm going to place the stethoscope a little bit higher on your chest here. I'm just going to tap. On the front of your chest. Okay. And again. On this side. Okay. And the front. I'm going to use the bell on my stethoscope. I'm going to place it on various areas of your neck. Okay, just going to listen for pulse. And the sounds of the air going through your windpipe. Have you been feeling any kind of congestion or anything like that? go a little bit further to your belly area here. We're just going to listen to the sounds of your tummy, sounds of your bowels. Okay. Was the last time you've had any food? Okay. Do you normally have large portion size or average? Okay. Okay. Well, audibly everything sounds good. I'm gonna put some gloves on, and with your permission, a couple of things. With pressure sensation in various areas of your body, is that going to be okay? It's not going to hurt. Okay, thank you. Just going to press on things like your liver. So right here. Okay, take a deep breath in for me. I'm going to press inward. Might be a little bit uncomfortable. Okay, go ahead and relax. I'm going to reach around to the back where your kidneys are. I push in and I palpate like this. Does this hurt? I know it doesn't feel that good, but it doesn't, there's no pain. Okay. Okay. I'm going to do light compressions along your large intestine. It goes up your right side, underneath your ribcage, and then it descends down to your colon on your left side, okay? For some people, this may be uncomfortable. Just let me know if you need to take a time out, okay? Okay. At the bottom of your ribs here. Does that feel okay? I'm also just feeling for any kind of lumps or bumps or masses of tissue that don't want to move. In the center where your bladder is. Okay. This can be very uncomfortable for people, so if it is, or if you're retaining water, just let me know and I'll stop, okay? Okay. Just want to make sure that everything's nice and healthy. No discomfort there. Any urgency? Okay. I'm gonna reach around and I'm gonna just have you take a deep breath in for me. This will allow me to feel the presence of your liver a little bit more accurately. And I'm gonna just kind of move it just around a little bit, okay? Take a deep breath in for me. Lining of your liver goes up towards your center. Okay. to restrictions. Beautiful. Okay. Thank you. Okay. I'm going to do some reflex testing next, if you're okay with it. So with my reflex hammer here, I'm going to start with your upper body, your shoulders, and your arms. Okay. If it's okay for me to maneuver your limbs, just let them go a little bit floppy. You don't need to assist me in moving them around, okay? I just want to see what your range of motion is first, and then we'll test your reflexes, okay? Great, thank you. So we'll start on your right side here. I'm just going to palpate the length of the arm. Tell me if there's any discomfort in any of these areas, okay? Your bicep. Your elbow. Beautiful. And your wrists. I'm going to intertwine my fingers into yours. Just going to kind of maneuver your wrist around. If I pull on it, does that hurt at all? Okay. The same on your left side. Area here. Bicep and your tricep. Good elbow rotation. Interlock my fingers into yours. Any of that hurt? Okay. Alright, I'm going to rotate your shoulder up and just hold it here for a moment. And I'm going to try to push it down and I want you to resist me, okay? Try to keep it elevated. Okay. Same on this side. You can go ahead and relax. Both of them up at the same time. Go like this. Okay, I'm going to try to push down. And on the opposite, I'm going to try to push up, and I want you to push me down. Perfect. I'm going to have you pull your arms close to your chest to make a fist. I'm going to try to pull your arms out, and I want you to try to pull them back into your chest, okay? Okay. Good job. Same thing, I'm going to push you, then you up. Push against me, okay? Ready? Very good. Nice and strong. I want you to grab onto my fingers here and give them a nice good squeeze, okay? You can squeeze harder, it's okay. Good job. Okay, I'm gonna take my reflex hammer and I'm gonna just gently tap you on your shoulder. Very good. Back of your elbow here. Very nice. Okay. And the front, I'm going to hit my finger, so I'm not going to hit the inside of your elbow. Okay. And your wrist. Just do this very quickly on your knees and your ankles. Is that okay? Alright. Just let your legs go floppy on the bed here. Okay. Squeaky gloves. Alright, and your backside of your ankle. top part of your foot where your adductor cells are. I'm sorry. And your left knee, just so you're like a floppy. And your ankle. Now your little metatarsals here. Alright. Very good. Very normal reflexes, so that's always good. So now we're going to move on to the cranial nerves. And for many people, this is actually the most fun. This is going to be most of the cranial senses that you have in your head. So everything from light, hearing, taste, touch, smell. It's going to be pleasant. Okay, so we're going to start with your sense of smell, and for this I have two different aromas. I want you to cover up one nostril, okay? And what do you believe this scent is? Lemon? Cinnamon, yep. If it makes you sneeze, I totally understand. It's okay. Okay, beautiful. I'm going to take my otoscope here. And I'm going to just lift up the tip of your nose. I want to take a look and see the tissue and the membrane inside your nose. Good, thank you. Good, do you get bloody noses or anything like that that you can? Tissue's nice and pink, looks nice and healthy, doesn't look too dry, doesn't look too runny. I'm gonna palpate your nose a little bit around the bridge. Anything like that? I'm going to hold up an object, and I want you to follow this with your eyes, but keep your head still. My magnifying lens here. I'm going to take a very close look into your eye. Is this going to be okay if I get fairly close to you? Okay, thank you. I'm just going to pull up on your eyelid a little bit here. And if you can, just try to focus on a point me, okay? Very nice. nice. I'm gonna give you just a moment here to recover here. I'm gonna take my thumbs and very gently press inward on your eyelids. After the bright light, it might actually feel a little bit good. Okay. Yeah, if you want to just relax, that's totally welcome. Okay, and under your eyes. Okay. Do you feel like you're tearing up another? Okay. Okay. Very good. Your eyes feel any better? Okay. Last one with the bright lights, okay. On a point somewhere behind me if you can. Constriction and dilation is very good. So I want you to focus on the light. I know it's not exactly the most comfortable, but it's going to get closer to you and it's going to be a little bit more uncomfortable. And just try to keep a steady gaze on it, okay? Okay, then we'll get back out. Down the lights. I'm gonna feel around your scalp area and just feel for any lumps and bumps, things that we should be paying attention to. And let me know if any of these areas feel uncomfortable or it feels like I'm pressing on a bruise or anything like that. If I hit an itchy patch or anything like that. Okay. All right. Okay, start here in the front. Your head from side to side here, and I'm just gonna feel where your vertebrae are rotating. Very nice. Okay. No pain. Okay. Go down your neck here. Move around to the front where your lymphatic nodes are along your jaw. Any discomfort here? I'm just going to push side to side a little bit more so you'll feel a little bit more pressure. On your forehead. Down the sides to your temples. Down your neck to your clavicle. Do you mind turning your head to one side? And I'm going to feel down your neck. Any discomfort? this down here. Does this hurt? No? Okay. Okay, have you look the other way? Okay. I'm just pressing a little bit here on the neck. Okay, to press right here. Around your clavicle area where your lymph glands continue to go down towards your armpits. Okay. Just gently palpating the area. Okay. I'm lifting up your arms just a little bit here. I tuck your shirt under here, but under your armpits here. But not painful. Okay, that's good. Wonderful. Alright. Let's take a look inside your mouth. Have you been experiencing any kind of discomfort, anything like that? Good. And when was the last time that you had seen a dentist? Okay. Just checking the back of your throat. Have you ever had strep throat, tonsillitis, anything like that? Just gonna move your cheek to the side here so I can see the other side of your teeth. Alright. Okay, I'm just gonna press your tongue down. Okay. Gag reflex, I'm sorry. I'm gonna pull your lip up here. Just taking a look at your top gums and your bottom. Lips look good, nice and pink. Very good. So the next portion of this is going to be a little bit more based on the perception of different frequencies and touch. So this is going to work with your audio sensory. So tell me when the sound fades to the point that you can't hear it. Okay. You hear that? Okay, now I'm going to move it away from your face. Tell me when you can no longer hear it. Good job. Same thing. This on the top of your head in various points, and you're going to feel it all over in your scalp. Tell me when that noise stops, okay? So you'll feel it pretty prominently right here. Good. And again. It's almost annoying, isn't it? Okay. Okay. I'm gonna touch it to the side of your ear. Really, really close. Okay. Not unpleasant, though. I'm going to take an object that has a soft little point, but nonetheless precise. And I'm going to be taking an object that has a slightly more abrasive point. And I want you to close your eyes for me, and I want you to tell me what item it is that you're being touched with. use the same object. I'm going to use that cotton swab. I'm going to touch your arm. Is this sensation over here the same as over here? Your perception of it? Lovely. Okay. Same. I'm going to do the same on your face. Is this the same over here? Because it is over here. Lovely. Concern was that you might have been experiencing some discomfort with your ears. The next part of the exam is going to focus on the ears, but if there's anything else that we can do to help make that a little bit more comfortable, let's see what we're looking at, okay? Alright, thank you. Okay, so I just put a new attachment onto my little ear tool here, and this will allow me to kind of go into the entry of the ear and get a little bit better to look, okay? Get a little bit close to you. Is that gonna be alright? Alright, thank you. And if it's okay, I might just pull on your earlobe and your arch of your ear just a little bit here. Okay. That does look a little bit irritating. Any soap, any rubbing alcohol or vinegar, anything like that. Okay. It's very dry. Okay. And I'm gonna get another head to check on the other ear here. Yeah, even though both your ears, sometimes you can get one side infected. Contaminate that, so I'm gonna put a new head on and just do a little look and see. Okay. Alright, and again, I'm just gonna pull on your ear a little bit. I'm gonna see how the membrane moves. It looks using something like peroxide, it feels good at the time, but it can also be very drying. There's a solution that we can give you for bacterial infection, so if you have something that's causing that itch and it's what's motivating you to itch that, we can probably get something to help resist it. Okay. But I would like to take some just basic saline, rinse the ear out a little bit. And once that material is softened up, we can probably pull it out with tweezers, as well as our little spoon, our illuminated spoon. Okay. So let me get some fresh cotton swabs. On contact lenses. So I'm just going to very liberally moisten the ear. Does that feel good? Okay, that feel alright? Look at my tweezers. Alright, I'm gonna start by using my little plastic spoon here. For one, it's a little more gentle, and if we don't need to go in there with a metal utensil, sometimes that's just more preferred. I'm gonna ask you to try to hold still as best you can for me. And usually once the skin gets to be very dry in these locations, it can be a little bit difficult to break off of the wall of the hair. Apply a little bit more saline. Moisten that up a little bit. Alright, I am going to take my tweezers and I'm going to try to gently pull some of that material out, okay? A little bit more saline. I'm gonna flush that out really nicely. Just gonna swirl that around on the inside. There we go, it's nice and cool, doesn't it? Alright. Ready to move on to the next one? Soaking a little bit longer, so this will hopefully be a little bit less dramatic, okay? Although I'll try to be gentle, as always. Get a new head. Thank you. saline. Use my tweezers. Just help to pull some of that debris out a little bit more. Good. You're doing so well. Sitting still. I know this can sometimes be a little bit unnerving and itchy. Feel better. It is still itchy. Let's push it out one last time. For the itchiness, I'm going to take my hands, I'm going to just press inward on the outer part and kind of maneuver, let the saline sink into the air a little bit more, okay? But that feels good, doesn't it? To make the itching stop out a bit. Okay. The last part of the hearing test is going to be for your desertion of letters and syllables. So I'm going to whisper into your ear numbers, and I want you to repeat back those numbers what you hear, okay? Concludes the cranial nerve portion of the examination. What I'd like to do is I'd like for you to stay positioned. I'm going to walk around back. I'm going to inspect your skin on your back, your vertebrae. Is that going to be okay? Okay. Alright. Okay. Okay. I'm just going to start at the base of your neck here. And palpate my way down your spine. Okay, and down here at the base by your pelvis here, I'm just going to palpate right above your hips. Okay. Right here. And just rubbing the skin on your back here, does any of this feel uncomfortable or anything like that? I'm going to palpate around your shoulders and your scapula here. Does this feel okay? No tenderness? Okay. And the sides, your obliques. My examination, and I thank you for allowing me to learn a little bit more and for being such an awesome patient. It's starting to rain, so at least that's got that nice comforting ending. And I will pass off my recommendations to see about a treatment for the ears. The saline would probably be a good cleanser to help ward off any kind of bacterial or fungal infection, and then possibly something additional to moisturize it so the inflammation and everything can go down, but that the tissue in the ear also stays nice and comfortable. It was a pleasure meeting you, and thank you again for being an awesome patient. Have a good afternoon.